Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. Here's a portion of an email I received. Hi, I'm Lucas from Brazil and I love your videos. Here's a problem from a book with math problems that I could not solve and the book doesn't say the answer. It just said, this one we leave to the students. I translated the problem for you and I'm also sending you a photo of the original problem and the book link from where I got the problem. I was so grateful to Lucas, I replied right away, thanks for writing and for translating too. I appreciate the original photo. So what was the problem? It was a false proof that 3 is equal to 0. Here's how it starts. Let x be a solution of x squared plus x plus 1 equals 0. Since x is not equal to 0, we can divide both sides by x. Let's simplify this to the following form. We have x plus 1 plus 1 over x is equal to 0. Now, from the first equation, we have x plus 1 is equal to negative x squared. We're going to substitute that into the second equation. So that first x plus 1 becomes negative x squared. Then we have plus 1 over x is equal to 0. We'll now rearrange this equation to get 1 over x is equal to x squared. This means 1 is equal to x cubed, so x is equal to 1. We now take x equals 1 and substitute it into our original equation, x squared plus x plus 1 equals 0. We get 1 squared plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 0, which means 3 is equal to 0. This is clearly a nonsensical result, but every single step seemed to be correct. So where is the mistake in this false proof that 3 is equal to 0? Can you figure it out? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the explanation. So let's take a look at this false proof. Which step introduces the mistake from which the ultimate result of 3 equals 0 originates? That would be between the second and third steps, where we substitute x plus 1 is equal to negative x squared. The problem with this step is that it creates an extraneous solution, x equals 1, which is not a solution to the original equation, x squared plus x plus 1 equals 0. So let me explain that in a little bit more detail. We start out where x is a solution of x squared plus x plus 1 equals 0. So far, so good. This has two solutions which we can get from the quadratic formula. We have negative 1 plus I times the square root of 3 all over 2, and we have negative 1 minus I times the square root of 3 all over 2. Now x is not equal to 0, so it is valid for us to divide both sides by x. Now we have a new equation, x plus 1 plus 1 over x is equal to 0. This equation again has the same two solutions. So far, so good. Now, we're going to substitute x plus 1 is equal to negative x squared. We get the equation negative x squared plus 1 over x is equal to 0. Now, what happens when you solve this equation? Well, you end up with another solution. So you have the same two solutions as before, but then you end up with a new solution of x equals 1. Notice if you substitute x equals 1 into this equation, you end up with negative 1 plus 1 equals 0. So x equals 1 is a solution to this equation, but it was not a solution to the previous two equations. So the lesson is that when we've substituted x plus 1 is equal to negative x squared, we've got an equation that has another solution, and this is not a solution to the original equation, x squared plus x plus 1 is equal to 0. So you have to be careful if a step introduces an extraneous solution, or else you could end up with a nonsensical result like 3 is equal to 0. Did you identify where the mistake originated? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions. If you like this video, you could check out my books, which are linked in the video description, and you can support me on Patreon. If you have a topic suggestion or a puzzle, you can email me, presh@mindyourdecisions.com, and you can catch me on social media, either at Mind Your Decisions or at Presh Tallwalker.